Hi, and welcome! Today, you'll learn everything about creating and customizing new files in Adobe Illustrator. We'll go through every option we can customize, why are they important, and what can we use them for. If you don't know me, hi, I'm Andy, I'm an Adobe Community expert, graphic designer, and decade-long user of Illustrator. So, let's get started. When we open Illustrator, we start on the home screen, and this is where we can find the New File button. Upon clicking it, we're greeted with the New File window. Despite having quite a lot of options and settings to mess around, they're all quite easy to understand. And the best part, there is no wrong setting that is irreversible. Everything here can be changed after the file is created, so do not worry about choosing the wrong option. The new file window can be divided into two sections. On the left, we have presets, and on the right, we have the options that are predefined on these presets. And presets are just that, they are predefined configurations of the options on the right. They don't add anything new, so we won't waste time talking about them. Just know that they exist, and in the future you can use them for a quick start. On the right, however, is where the important options lie, so let's go through them one by one. The very first option is the name of the file, and we can give it any name we want. This is the name that appears on the File tab inside Illustrator, and the name that appears when we're saving our file. The way we change this after the file is created is by saving the file with a different name or by changing the name on the .ai file on our computer. Next, we can customize the size of our file. And when we say size of the file, we actually mean the size of the artboard inside the file. We have the width and the height of the artboard, and on the right, the measurement unit being used. For web or digital designs, we stick to pixels. But for printing, we use the appropriate unit, like inches or millimeters. This will change depending on where you live and what you're printing. You probably won't measure an outdoor in inches or use millimeters in the US. Below the measurement unit, we can also change the orientation between landscape and portrait, which will just invert the width and height, and set up how many artboards we want, in case we're working on a multi-page project. All artboards will have the same size, but we can change them individually later. Once again, all these options can be changed after the file is created. The size can be changed by selecting the artboard tool, then selecting the artboard we'd like to resize, and changing the width and height on the control bar up here. Also on the control bar is where we can change the orientation and add or remove artboards. To change the measurement unit, we have to toggle the rulers by going to the View menu, then Rulers and Show Rulers, or by using the shortcut Ctrl-R. Once the ruler is visible, we can right-click on it and change the measurement unit. Back to the new file window, after the file size, we can add a bleed, which is something exclusive to printing. Bleed in printing is when the design extends beyond the edge of the page to ensure no white borders are left after the paper is trimmed. We can use the link button on the right to make sure all sides have the same bleed size. After the file is created, the bleed will appear as a red outline outside the artboard, and we can change the bleed by going to the File menu, then Document Setup, or by using the shortcut Ctrl-Alt-P. Next, we have a few options hidden under the Advanced Options, the first one being Color Mode. Color Mode refers to how colors are created and displayed in different mediums. Screens like TVs and monitors reproduce colors using the RGB color mode, mixing red, green, and blue light to create all other colors. So, if our design will be used digitally, like an Instagram post or a website banner, we choose the RGB option. Meanwhile, printers use the CMYK color mode to reproduce colors on the paper by mixing cyan, magenta, yellow, and black ink. Logically, if our design will be printed, like business cards or flyers, that's the color mode we choose. After the file is created, we can change the color mode by going to the File menu, then Document Color Mode, and choosing CMYK or RGB. After color mode, we have the option to choose a resolution for raster effects. Illustrator is a vector drawing software, but some effects are rendered as raster images. Or, in simpler words, some effects are displayed as pixels. And this option allows us to choose the resolution in which these effects will be displayed. On the drop-down menu, we have four options: 36, 72, 150, and 300 ppi, which stands for pixels per inch. 72 ppi is the default for screens, so if you're designing four screens, that's enough resolution. Printing uses higher resolutions like 150 or 300. To know which effects in Illustrator are rendered as raster effects, you can simply zoom in. If you see pixels, then it's a raster effect. Usually, they are effects where color fades or blends in some way, like shadows and blurs, since vectors can only ever be solid shapes. To change the raster effects resolution after the file is created, we can go to the Effect menu, then Document Raster Effect Settings, and use the drop-down menu there. Back to the new file window, the last option is the Preview mode, which determines how we view the artwork on our project. The default option doesn't change anything and just displays the artwork as it is. The pixel option displays the artwork as it will be if exported as a raster image, so a JPEG or a PNG for example. If you zoom in, instead of the vectors being constantly rendered, they will now appear as raster images, or as pixels. The overprint option, as the name implies, is exclusive for printing, and it is a tad more complex to explain. On a design that will be printed, if we have two shapes overlapping each other, we can choose to overprint the object on top by selecting the object and checking the Overprint Fill option on the Attributes panel. This means that the object on the bottom will be completely printed before the other object is printed on top, even on parts where they overlap. This, obviously, causes colors to mix, since you're adding two layers of color on top of each other. Overprint Preview allows us to see how these colors will interact when overprinted. However, it's important to know that only objects marked for overprint will be previewed like this. If we uncheck the Overprint Fill option, the color mixing goes away. Preview options can be changed at any time after creating the file by going to the View menu and choosing the Preview option there. At the very bottom of the new file window, we have a button labeled More Settings, but oddly enough, it only opens a window with the same options on a different layout. This is, in fact, an older version of the new file window, which for some reason was kept under the More Settings button. But don't worry, there's nothing new there. If you enjoyed this video, check this other one here. A special thanks to all my Patreon supporters who help me make high quality content like this one. More on how you can support the channel in the description down below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave a comment if you have any doubts. Thank you so much for watching, and have a great day. Bye!